If the subscription models for Midjourney, DALL-E, Photoshop and Co. scare you off from using generative AI, I have a super easy, fast and free tool for you. Its name is Focus, a very clean and user-friendly stable diffusion web UI that you can run without having to install anything. All you have to do is head over to the GitHub repository via the link in the description and click on download. This will download a 1.8GB archive, but be prepared, we will need some more space on our hard drive later. Since the compressed file comes in the 7z format, it is helpful to have 7zip on your computer to unpack it. If you don't have 7zip installed yet, quickly check the video description again and open the second link. There you can download the latest 7zip for your system, which probably is the 64-bit Windows version. With 7zip installed, you can right-click on the archive, search for 7zip, which might be hidden under Show More Options, and unpack it. Now, as I promised, you don't have to install anything since Python, on which Stable Diffusion is running, is already embedded. Thus, we can simply double-click either the run bat, run anime bat, or run realistic bat file. Let's just use the standard Focus for now. This will start your terminal. When you run Focus for the first time, it will start downloading the most important stuff, meaning the Stable Diffusion XL model and refiner. That is the thing that is trained to know what a tree, a cat, and all the other stuff is that you can create through the AI. So these files are quite large and will take a moment to download. Just make sure that you have some 10 to 20 gigabytes left on your hard drive in order not to run out of space while downloading. Once everything is downloaded, the terminal should either start your default web browser itself, or it will simply tell you that it started running on a local host. If it doesn't open right away, you can press the control key and click on the link that should start with 127. Then the browser should open and the web UI should appear. Of course, you can also just type the address in the browser of your choice as well. So now we have a simple interface with a text box where we can put our prompt and add generate button to start generating the image. Let's start with something like detailed space helmet made from white, blue, Chinese porcelain, neutral background. While the image is generating, let's briefly talk about the system requirements for Focus and Stable Diffusion. The performance of Stable Diffusion depends on the system's graphics card. I have a Razer laptop with an Nvidia RTX 3080, which works quite smoothly without causing all too high temperatures. Generally, Nvidia GPUs will work better with Stable Diffusion, and the more VRAM you have, the better. However, Focus is really good at supporting lower performance devices. For example, I got Focus to work on a 4GB VRAM Nvidia GeForce GTX 970 from 2014. In comparison, I couldn't get the other popular Stable Diffusion web UI, Automatic 1111, to run on that PC at all. Of course, it's slower, but it works nonetheless. You can check your GPU and VRAM by pressing Ctrl, Shift and Escape. This should open the task manager. Therein you can navigate to the performance tab. You should then see your system's most important components. On laptops you will commonly find two GPUs, one to run the display and a second more powerful one. Find the more powerful one, scroll down and check the dedicated GPU memory. That is your VRAM. Anything above 4GB should be fine to run Focus. Now that we have our image, we can start to optimize our prompt a little bit. For example, I want to focus a little bit more on detailed and porcelain. The easiest way to put more weights on these keywords is by putting round brackets around them. One pair of brackets will increase the keyword's weight by a factor of 1.1. Two pairs of round brackets will increase the weight by 1.21, and three will assign a weight of 1.33. Similarly, we can also put less weight on a keyword by using square brackets. There, one pair assigns a weight of 0.9, two will give a weight of 0.81, and three a weight of 7.3. With those changes, let's have a look at the results. That looks quite nice already. So as you can see, we can do a lot only with a few inputs. However, as you might have already noticed, there are two more checkboxes under the prompt input. We will get to the image input later, so let's first focus on the advanced settings. You might have already asked yourself either what the resolution of the image is or whether we can change the ratio. The answer to both of those questions lies in the first tab of the advanced settings. Here we can select a range of resolutions for our image. Unfortunately, you cannot easily input your own own resolutions, but we already have something to work with. Above the resolutions, you can also select whether you want to focus on speed or quality. By default, it is set to speed, which means that Stable Diffusion uses 30 steps to go from a random noise to your final image. When you set focus to quality mode, it will use 60 steps. To better understand what these steps mean, you can check out the brilliant video by Computerphile, who explain how diffusion models work and how you can go from a random Gaussian noise to a detailed image. It's important to note that more steps do not always equal a more beautiful image, since the AI might start breaking what looks like a pretty photo by going through more denoising steps. So 30 steps or the speed mode is often sufficient. But let's switch to quality mode for demonstrational purposes anyway. Underneath the resolution selection, you can find the negative prompt window. For example, now we see a bit too many metallic elements, which I didn't ask for in the positive prompt. Probably it's a byproduct of some other keyword, but if we want to avoid getting that, we can put it in here. Lastly, we have the random checkbox at the end of the first tab. If it is checked, it means that it will insert a random number as the seed of the initial noise. This is something like the DNA of the image. If we have the same prompt and settings with the same seed, it will always produce the same image. However, if you keep the same settings and prompt but with a different seed, it will return something different. You can also check the seed that was used for an image after the fact, but we will get to that in a minute. For the moment, let's uncheck random so that you can see the seed and principally create an identical image to mine. So let's generate a new image with the changed settings. It looks slightly different now, but it's still the same basic style. If we want to change the style, we can go to the next step in the advanced settings. By default, focus has its own style selected, which already produces really nice images. However, we also have a long list of options, like a very long list. In fact, so long that I usually just use the shortcut Ctrl plus F to search for a style that way. And usually there is something fitting in there. How about searching for something like futuristic? Here we go. Simply select the styles we want. In this case, let's use futuristic biomechanical and futuristic biomechanical cyberpunk and press generate again to get our new image. We can already see the changes, and with those advanced options, you can already do a lot. So let's just have a brief look at the additional settings. For one, we can change the model and the LoRa to have a bit more control, but focus's setup is already really good, and if you don't know what LoRAs and models are, feel free to just ignore this for the moment. Lastly, we get some more options for the sampling sharpness, also something that you usually don't have to change, and the guidance scale option. This one is a bit more important. The higher the number is, the more Stable Diffusion will try to follow your prompt. If, for example, you feel like Stable Diffusion doesn't really do what you say, you can up this value to make it stick more to the prompt. This can produce much better images in some cases, but may also completely break it in others. You can see how the guidance scale impacts the image on this website, which I also linked below. Now we have created a few images, but we don't really know where they are saved yet. For that, we simply go back to the main folder where we started the run.bat file. There we open the focus folder and search for outputs. If you don't always want to click your way there, you can also right-click the folder, show more options and create a shortcut. Then we can rename the shortcut and put it on our desktop anywhere we want. If we open the folder, we see a subfolder with the date that contains all the images we have created thus far. It also contains a log.html file. If we open that, we get an overview of all the images, including all the settings such as the prompt, negative prompt, style and seed, so that we can recreate the image or create more images in a similar style. You can also open the log from within the web UI. Since we have access to our images now, we can check the next function in focus. That is the image input area. If we select the checkbox, we can insert an image and do some stuff with it. Let's start by creating some variations first. Let's drag and drop this image in there and select very strong and click on generate. We can either do that with no prompt and negative prompt, or we can insert a new similar prompt to guide the changes. As you can see, we can also upscale the image, but let us get to that a bit later. First, we can go to the image prompts, where you can use a series of images to substitute our text prompt. What I find more interesting though is the in-painting and out-painting better of focus. Here we can make a selection in the image and then use a new prompt to make a new generation for that particular area of the image. Let's insert orchids lying on the floor, still life white blue here. Now we can also change the style again and set the seed to random. When we do this for the first time, Focus first has to download the inpainting module, so you have to bring a bit more patience once more. This doesn't always work as expected, but I assume this feature will get better over time. Now, if we don't necessarily want to change something inside of the image, but simply make it larger, we can use the outpainting feature and extend the image. So let's add something to the left and to the right. Let's assume that we're happy with this. Now we can go back to the first tab, insert the new image and upscale it. We could have also upscaled it earlier, but then all the following manipulations of the image would have taken longer. So it makes sense to do the upscaling last. The upscale 2x fast works really well and only takes a few seconds, so let's do that. We can repeat this as often as we want, although the returns usually diminish after 2x upscaling in my experience. And with that, we have created a high resolution AI-generated image locally on our machine for free. There's an entire world of Stable Diffusion web UIs, models, LoRAs and many more things, but I find Focus the easiest and fastest way to get started. I hope you found this interesting and helpful. If you have any questions or feedback, don't hesitate to leave a comment, subscribe and turn on the notifications so that you won't miss any videos in the future. I'll see you in the next one.